After 5 years of Comrade Adams Oshiomole as the executive governor of Edo State, the people of Edo State were once again told they would have the opportunity to choose their local government representatives. This was particularly important to the people because it was the first local elections that would be done under Governor Oshiomole. Election is one of the founding principles in a democracy. It places the power within the people, and it allows us to play a part in our government. Everything from legislation to other matters, such as the presidential election. How the overwhelming population decide what is best for them is absolutely the right thing for the country as a whole. Otherwise, you can look at the alternatives, dictatorships, or any other tyrannical government that wishes to impose its will on the people rather than the people imposing its will on it. It was based on this power of ownership that the people of Edo State trooped out en masse as early as 6 a.m. on Saturday, April 20th, 2013, to vote for a candidate of their choice. The enthusiasm of the anxious voters soon turned out to be one of doubt and skepticism when materials for the election did not arrive on time. They could not understand why, after 5 years of not conducting election and 4 months of preparation, ESEC could not deliver in their duty as to the conducting of a hitch-free local election in the state.
As you can see, there is a little bit of anxiety because the materials that can be used for the election, for people to exercise their franchise, is yet to arrive. It's supposed to be by 8. The state director has postponed it twice, from 8 to 10, and 10 now to 11. So there's a little bit of worry as to whether the process will be credible.
These people have been here, hundreds of them. They've been here for over 6-7 hours for an election which was supposed to start by 8 o'clock, and now it is 1 o'clock. Nothing has happened.
Well, for us, the concern are people. They are very ready, but unfortunately, the state government is not ready. We can see the timeline is about 11:25 a.m. Materials are yet to come, and the accreditation ought to have started by 8 a.m. That will show you how shoddy the arrangement of the state government has been. For us, we are convinced now that the government was not serious about conducting any election. I'm sure because of the pressure that has been mounted since yesterday, they know they had no choice. I mean, we have a governor who has been preaching one man, one vote. And we dare him to walk his talk. And this is a testament to the fact that he does not mean it whenever he says one man, one vote. Otherwise, they have all this past number of years to organize this local government election. And it is instructive. This is the first local government election that his administration will be organizing since about 5 years ago. And you can see the outcome of their preparation, which means they are not prepared. So enough of the deceit, and we are saying that democracy must take root at the local government level. So we know why this is happening, because the governor is trying to convert the resources of the local government, and the people are saying no to that. And that is why the people have come out en masse to express their choice, their interest, and vote the person of their choice so that their resources can be better managed. We will wait for as long as it takes us to vote today. We are determined to wait. So we will not live here for there. It is our local government. We must decide who rules this local government.
But was the late arrival of election materials a genuine logistic issue or a strategy to manipulate the electoral process?
For him to damage a vehicle, my own vehicle, the bus, conveying our own people from the world headquarters, bringing electoral materials, I think he has finally nailed his own coffin.
Anticipated some kind of hijacking of electoral material.
Yes.
By the person of the deputy governor, who has openly said his boss, his people, in the vehicle.
And
carrying materials. To an unknown destination.
Is he a member?
And he himself also said that those who did it, they have nailed their own coffin,
yes.
Which means he's going to fight back violently.
Yes.
That is wrong.
Yes.
That is not the way to behave.
Like
no, no.
Yes.
That is not the way to behave as a politician.
Yes.
As a leader.
Yes.
He's number two in Edo State.
Yes.
It can't be that kind of.
And it raises a lot of suspicion.
And it has raised the suspicion
that something is fishy.
He has attempted to do something bad.
Yes.
And he was stopped.
It's unfortunate. It's unfortunate that a number two man will pick a bus. Well, I have no problem with that. Government officials can be in the bus. But where have the problem? Where I'm very, very worried for electoral materials to be in the bus of the number two man of the state. I mean, it's appalling. Yeah. It's appalling. It means something is wrong somewhere. And when people start to raise suspicion about a particular party being involved in election, it is so obvious that something is wrong.
Edo State Labour Party Chairman, Honorable Sam Omende, thought the whole experience was unfortunate.
We know we are going to rig the election, we are going to ride the election, but let's do it in a more civilized way. How do we do it? Frustrate them. Frustrate those people that are going to vote. Because we now know that some of the candidates are not worthy of going for election. Therefore, in order for us to defend them is to frustrate the electorate, the voters, by delaying materials. This election you announced about 4 or 5 months ago, you printed materials and everything. You are still saying materials are not ready at about 4 p.m. on the election day. It's a shame. I didn't expect that from Oshiomole. Of everybody in Nigeria, I didn't expect that from Oshiomole. Oshiomole disappointed me personally. He failed woefully.
Intimidating and creating fears was another major tool used to manipulate the electoral process.
If you assess the situation here now, I've observed that thugs were recruited from other places to Ovia Northeast, from other places to River. If you watch, many of these people are not from Ovia Northeast. And if we profess one man, one vote, we should respect that slogan.
At Esan North East local government, one thing was setting in their minds. They were going to vote for the candidates that will help bring positive developments to the place.
The local government, because of the past deed of the then chairman Yakubu, everybody want to exercise their franchise and vote for John Yakubu, Ehiva Choma Yakubu. I think that is the mood now, right now.
We don't vote for party. We vote for personality. That is, what have you done? And what do you want to do? That is it.
It's about performance, that the people will not listen to any black men. They know the characters of the people who are vying. Both of them have been tested and they know their pedigree. So at the end of the day, the man who has been sent to have performed will carry the day, and that is our candidate. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The anxiety and doubt as to if the election we hold in Esan North East soon turned to some form of agitation. The fact that there was shortage of electoral materials when they eventually arrived did not help issues. It led to fears of electoral malpractices.
We are told now that the materials that they brought are incomplete for an election that the comrade governor knows that even since January that there will be an election today, he's ill-prepared for it.
I am the cancellorship candidate representing Ward 5 in Esan North East local government. Today is supposed to be the election day. Up till now, we've not seen material. And with the time I'm seeing now, it's almost 2 or after 2 p.m. We've not seen the materials. And if the INEC fails to supply the materials by now, I think that is what they call negligence of duty. And the government has also paid for these materials to be given to all the local government, the wards and the units in Esan North East local government, likewise the 18 local government in Edo State. And if they fail to do that and the money has been supplied, which means they are not ruling us well.
I came from all the way from Ekuma to vote for the candidate of my choice. Still yet, no material, nothing. I have exam to write, which is on Monday. How can I make it again now? I'm disappointed in the governor. The present governor is confusing everybody. It's like we are nobody.
This is sad. It is absurd that we have an unstable and an imprecise government in this state. How can election that has been scheduled to take place for about 4 months ago, and up till now, the materials are not ready? It is very clear that the government of this state is imprecise and it can't take us to the promised land.
Okay.
So what is your opinion about what is going on?
My opinion is that I don't think that we can continue this anymore. I guess we now have to go home. I'm tired.
You have to go home?
Yeah.
I think what we are experiencing now is high level of incompetence and insincerity on the level of those that are saddled with the responsibility to carry out this election. You cannot see the vibrant, eloquent youth. They have been here since 6 o'clock. You can see the old women, you can see the men. They've been here to come and exercise their franchise to our greater dismay. At this point in time, no material. None of their staff that is even on ground to address us, to tell us these are the problem. We are here stranded. We are here confused. We don't know what to do, whether to remain here, whether to retire back to our various destination. I once again put it, what we are experiencing now is a big shame on Edo State government. This is an election that has been slated for more than 3 months. Yes. And we have not been waiting that this day we will come out to vote for the candidate of our choice. Yes. But everybody are saying Yakubu, Yakubu. Yes. But no ballot paper to vote for Yakubu and vote for Ugege. Yes. So I strongly believe the press, they should carry this issue out and find out what are the reasons. What are the reasons behind the hoarding of this ballot paper? I strongly believe they are hoarding it for their selfish interest. I once again put it, this is insincerity, incompetence at the level of Edo State government. Great youth, we will not live here. We will not live here until we see the ballot paper. So vote and vote and vote for the candidate of our choice. Thank you.
What is going on here is that we are aware, or we know, or you can see that ESIEC is not ready for today's election. And that's what the people are saying, that if you're not ready for today's election, give us another day for election. It is about 2 p.m. and they are yet to distribute material. And what we even have, the worst is that the result sheets are not available. How do you then conduct an exam without the result sheets? So that's what we're saying. If you want us to have a free, credible election, let the material be there, give us the result sheets, so that at the end of the day, whatever result we get will be recorded. So we don't want to have an election. While we're having an election in the polling booth, the result is being written somewhere else. That's exactly what the people are saying, and you can observe it yourself. If by 2 o'clock we're not having an election, what kind of election then can you have between 3 and 6 o'clock? And the poll are supposed to close by 5 o'clock. So that is exactly what I'm saying. It has happened in the Redo. Ekpama is saying no. Ubiaja is saying no. And that is sad that the present government cannot conduct a free and credible local government election.
Development in Esan South East was even more disturbing. Over 600 people did not vote in Uboha because of late arrival and shortage of materials. Amazingly, the local government was declared in favor of the ACN candidates and sworn in the next day.